All right, hey folks, Nathan here. Welcome. This is my channel, usually Star Wars materials or some live streams, including PlayStation VR. Lots of sort of first takes and first little chunks of games to give you a sense of what they are, to give you a sense of whether or not to pick up a PlayStation VR, if you can even find one these days, or whether or not you may be interested in certain things for it, certain games. We're in the menu system here of Resident Evil 7 Biohazard, which, by the way, can be played in either full VR or fully in VR, might be a better way to put it, or can be played normally as a regular first-person shooter type game. I am going to do this in PSVR. I actually played through the beginning hour as a demo, at least getting an infected ending. I just recently did a full-blown run-through. Not on live stream where I managed to get the dirty coin and get the true ending and all that, so I do have a little extra item here in game. But after playing through that a few times now and then playing the real beginning hour of this, holy crap, the real thing is so much better, and the demo was actually pretty sweet. So we're going to do the first little chunk here up into the first major transition. It doesn't really matter which difficulty we use, so we'll just use normal. I know you'll notice that Madhouse is already unlocked. Basically, I pre-ordered this, so I've got some pre-order stuff attached to it. Plus, I've got the season pass, and one of those, I forget which off the top of my head, but one of them was what made Madhouse automatically available. But it's otherwise, it would not be at this point. So we're gonna go with normal. That's all controlled with the DualShock 4 controller. There are no move controls for this. You do need the sticks because you're going to be moving around and whatnot. And it's an immersive environment, really immersive, and looks pretty good. It looks like you've been dropped into a Resident Evil game.
Hey, baby. I just wanted to send a quick hello and I love you. Oh, good news. I'm going to be coming home soon. Yay! I cannot wait to be done with this babysitting job and come home to my loving
Babysitting
husband.
what or who?
I miss you.
And it's by the sea.
Oh, I gotta get back to work. I love you, Ethan. I miss you so much. I'm sending tons of kisses.
Now, for what it's worth,
Bye,
all of
baby.
this is done in what's basically cinematic mode. So if I look left or right, I'm not seeing that type of environment. Cut scenes like this work like cinematic mode, I guess, so they work the same with regular play.
Ethan, you were right. I did lie to you. I shouldn't have. All I can say is if you get this, stay away.
She told you to stay away. I'm just saying. Sometimes maybe do what the wife tells you you should do. Maybe she's looking out for you, or go into crazy town. Again, still cinematic
Hey,
mode.
it's Ethan.
Oh, hey. You all right? You just disappeared the other night.
Yeah, no, I'm good. I'm good. It's Mia. She's not dead, she's alive. She's back.
They found her?
She's not
How?
dead, she's alive.
What happened?
I don't know. Look,
it's Resident
I don't
Evil,
know
so
how,
those aren't the only
but
two
she's
options.
back. She's back somehow. Maybe it's a prank. She wants me to come and get her.
Where is she?
Dolby, Louisiana.
Dude, it's been 3 years.
I know, but what if it is her? I have to find out what happened.
All right, we're going to switch from cinematic for just a second. So this is still cinematic as he's pulling up. And you can see the defined edges of the screen here. If I go too far in any direction, it's telling me up. Just line that back up by holding options. But now we're in full VR. Can't interact myself, but I can turn, I can look inside the car. I get out automatically. Okay, but now we're in
This
full
place.
VR. Now, from a control standpoint, you can set various options. I've got it set up to actually play a lot like Robinson the Journey. You do your click on the left stick, or excuse me, the right stick to turn, but it does it in small little increments, so it's less likely to give you motion sickness. Right? So we have our area here. Notice the textures are okay. We're going to see the same thing with the individual characters and whatnot. So when I say it feels like you've been dropped inside a Resident Evil game, think like Resident Evil 4, 5, or 6. Bugs. It's like you've been dropped into one of those games, from a graphical standpoint as well, except you're actually inside it, is the way that it feels. If that makes any sense. And of course, it's first-person shooter either way, or first-person survival horror either way, whether inside VR or not. You do have more options outside of VR, like brightness controls. You do not have that in VR because there's an optimization already in place. So I can click on my touchpad on the left-hand side. And this is a little actually tough to read, unless you're like up by it like this, when you're actually in VR, but you can see your files, you can see your map. Okay, your objective to find Mia. While you're in that, you can also press a button to see your controls, including the legend and so on. Walking up to the creepy house. This should be a house that does not really look familiar to those who played the demo. The house we were in the demo wasn't nearly this large. It's actually, it turns out it's the guest house is the one we were in the demo. Well, damn. Anybody home? Hello? Hello? Guten Tag. Shit. Scheiße! Again, very immersive. Lots of detail. But from a texture standpoint, looking through the VR, it's almost like there's too much. To the point where the detail gets a little bit grainy. The finer details get a little bit grainier. You played the demo, the beginning hour. Oh, look. It's the van that our guys took when they came to film the ghost house in the VHS tape. Which is also a part of this scenario, only in a slightly different way. Check inside here. The van. Sewer Gators. Episode 17. Notice the text that I'm reading is floating essentially in front of me. I can turn my head and it floats. Whereas the object is able to be rotated and whatnot in front of me. Alright, so I guess we're going through this gate now, man. Accept her gift. Maybe the gift was to tell you to stay the hell away. But you're like, nah, man, I'm Ethan, so I think I'm Ethan Hunt. Like I'm in Mission Freaking Impossible. I can do whatever I want. Okay, a lot of this kind of walking up here at the beginning, just through the creepy atmosphere or the bayou atmosphere. You can see, like, as you walk, you can see, like, the bottom halves of your arms, the same ones you can pull up like this to defend. And notice their data just walked by. So I can do this. You're aiming essentially, like, when you're standing still, you're looking around when you move your head. If you are walking, it does help direct you just a little bit. If you've got that option turned on, you'll be aiming using it as well. So when I hold down L1 to do this, then it moves with me. All right, let's run. There are so many crows here, I expect Eric Draven to be assisting me. Again, if someone has something like this set up in their backyard, maybe stay away. Because that's like parts of cows and shit. Crouch. Yeah, there are some odd moments when you're in the VR as it takes over and essentially does the little duck under type things. But there's some serious immersive holy crapness with the ducking under thing momentarily. So depending on your level of being afraid of certain things, it could wind up creeping you out. Dead birds! I wanted to kill them after they flew out at me. I just didn't think it was going to happen. Okay, this is a little trippy in VR because you got to just walk forward, basically, and Whoop! I'm okay! Now we're back at basically the house from the thing from the demo. Check in here. What's in here? A driver's license. We got an email from that apparently is from Mia saying. Dun, 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 nothing on the back. Saying, Dover, Louisiana, Baker Farm, come get me. Oh, sorry, that sounded a little bit more like a Trump tweet than it was otherwise. And you can't read this, but it is her driver's license, covered in a strange black substance. And here we are coming up on the front of the home. Bit more grown over than in the demo. At least when we were outside. But again, that's all VHS tape years ago kind of stuff. It's one of our ghost girl locations from the demo over there. And in this case, the door is already wide open. Darkness. All right. So I've got my light. That is not something you turn on and off. It's not something that acts like an inventory item or anything. The light is just there when you need it, basically. Open door. And you either open it partway and push, just like push through it, or you can do that whole double click type thing. But you're not kicking it like the previous Resident Evil games. You're just like part open, full open. No crazy kicking. If you're trying to do the demo and you're still having trouble seeing all the ghost girls, there's another location she can be. For the love of God, why is this thing always locked? Right, so far it feels nice and relatively familiar. Slow, but relatively familiar to someone who has played the beginning hour. Which, again, is not really the beginning hour. The beginning hour demo is a different scenario. You do have your locked drawer still if you played the demo. Some random pictures of stuff. Tim! From the demo.
Fuck.
Or something similar to Tim. Yes, I said Tim like a person's name. Got to solve some murders in the demo. Over 20 missing in 2 years. Okay. Another ghost girl location for demo folks. And another. Okay. So we're here. Let's check. Nope, nothing useful. Nothing useful. And we can go upstairs. Now, some changes from the demo. Again, no mannequins. This is not going to work on our first try. Right? Very much like in the demo there. And then this is a little different because here's your VHS tape. So something else must be in the cabinet that's chained closed. And here's a tape recorder. This old school 1980s tape recorder, if you click it, that is your save ability. Alright, so I'm not going to do any saving here just because that throws you out when I do. Alright, so no saving. My things are going all whack now. I'm getting bleong, bleong, bleong. All kinds of sounds. Hopefully all is well. Side room is still the side room. VHS room. Can't do anything with that door yet. So, we're into our main room again. Some stuff to pick up and look at. Again, no fuse. Close that up. There is again a your little trapdoor switch down there, but there seems to be no benefit in actually clicking the trapdoor right now instead of after the VHS. Whereas in the demo, you do want to go in there first thing. Let's use the VHS tape. And it's pretty much set up the same way as what we see in the beginning hour demo for the VHS tape. But its effect is a little bit different. Clancy Javis. Abandoned house. Boo.
Boo.
Pete is still an asshole.
Find this guy? Give me a break, Pete. Hey, I only work with professionals. Speaking of which, make sure the sound is right this time. I don't want a repeat of Amarillo.
That was 2 fucking years ago.
I don't do ADR.
I have seen this so freaking many times.
New guy? I'm not feeling it. Again? Just don't be surprised if we have to make a change.
Pete, you know I'm like right here, right?
We do a walkthrough of the inside
Jackass.
First. Then we shoot the intro.
Just like we always do.
If you're trying to play this in the demo,
the show's name this time, okay?
Right around the time he's talking about ADR, the ghost girl could show up right over here.
Another worthless fucking shithole.
In order to get the true ending
Static.
For the demo, you have to see the ghost girl or you cannot activate the fifth murder to solve. You can find the doll in the basement to activate it, but it won't do the little girly giggle, the ghost giggle, which means you won't be able to actually solve the murder no matter how much you try.
All right, let's go.
Those moths are freaky. Because they're right up in your face. Yo, VIP.
It's locked.
Let's kick it. All right.
After you.
Callbacks. All right.
So, why are we in hell this time? Do you ever prep? What's
nope.
The prep? Shitty house, spooky sound. Ooh, is it haunted?
If you're playing the demo,
fuck me.
It's when he says
an
nothing.
Anchor, you know?
Weekend sub, Pete. Not anchor.
What's that?
Nothing.
Flip, she could be right there upside down at the ceiling. Again, if you're playing the demo, not the regular
Sorry,
game.
Andre.
Abandoned farmhouse, missing family, foul play suspected. The usual.
So, a horror movie then.
This place has been abandoned?
3 years.
Clancy, get a shot of
Damn.
This. Let's make a great cutaway.
All right, now a couple interesting bits.
Hillbilly Joe and his family go missing.
Not hillbillies, the Bakers.
When he's defending
Jack
the Bakers,
Baker.
There's the next place out the window where the ghost could show up in the demo.
A lot of bad rumors.
But unlike the demo, there's no lockpick down here. So you can't unlock the drawer over here.
Shit. I know I should have worn my good
for your
shoes.
Future incarnation or whatever.
Oh, shit. Glad I had my shots.
Ghost sighted in by you.
Although, this would make a great backdrop.
Dude, don't...
Andre, what do you think?
Andre, damn it.
Andre?
Yeah, he bailed.
Andre!
Now we gotta go find his stupid ass.
Andre!
Alright, next ghost girl location in the demo, if you need it, could be up here. As he's saying this.
Where is he?
Or, right as he's saying that, she could be standing on the stairs.
This is the last time I work with that guy. I mean, producers, they come and go, but a good cameraman like you,
Or, as he's talking...
You stick with me.
She could be flashing in that little viewing area of this room, like right in front there, trying to aim my head at it. I think Andre may have just bailed.
What the fuck was that?
That or he's breaking shit.
Did you hear that?
Yes, I'm not deaf. Gotta get very sarcastic with this guy because of how many
Andre!
Times I've watched this. It took me 4 times to finally see the frickin' ghost girl. And that was when I was trying. In the demo. So. I could almost repeat this sequence back. Word for word. No fuse. No VCR on top of the TV. What'd you find there, Pete?
What the hell?
Oh, you found a switch.
You gotta be fucking kidding me. Alright, new deal. We find Andre and we go. I mean, fuck this show.
How about, you know, we just go. Fuck the show and Andre. I'm just saying. Andre left us. He's the douche. If we leave, we're just smart. Just saying. Oh, look, it's Andre, and he's just standing there.
First,
that looks great.
Need a nice hero shot of me coming down the ladder. So, you first.
Asshole. The other place she could show up is right there. She could be, like, right in front of you as you're climbing down. Either way, you gotta see her in the demo, otherwise you can't do that fifth murder. Without it, you can't get the dirty coin, which is the one thing from the demo that carries over into the regular game.
What do you see? What is it?
A basement? And Andre, who looks like he's taking a pee? Nope, he's not. And he's on his tippy-toes! Okay, hey, Andre, what's up? Sorry, Andre. And look, the giant. Now, the effects. Now, playing through it, the only thing that's really different there is, of course, the missing lockpick, so you couldn't go ahead and unlock the drawer that will eventually get you the axe in the demo. But this is different, right? And as soon as you activate it and finish it, you don't have Daddy walking along the hallway freaking you the hell out. Okay, so there are some differences, despite the fact that the VHS segment looks like it's exactly the same thing. It's not really. It's damn close. But not completely. All right, so I can't go anywhere else at this point. No table with a fuse, like in the demo. Nor is there the key left there, like in the demo, once you watch the VHS tape. And in the present, in the demo, you can't go down here. There is no ladder anymore. Now there is. Oh, goody. It's the moment when I was like, oh, shit. And it looks like there's a flare on the floor or a fuse on the floor, but there's not. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Uh-oh. Oh, damn. Ow. Oh, floating hands. Oh, wait. They're mine. Oh. That was fun. Andre, leave me anything? Of course not. Now we're moving into an area we've never seen before, if you played the beginning hour demo. This is where I was, you know, pretty stoked. But this up here, we're talking about VR immersion. We can make that immersion a double meaning here. That looks like it got some crap in it. And if you're watching this as I'm playing, right? Basically, it feels like the water level is right at my chin or around my mouth, okay? I can sort of stand and pop up if I want, but yeah. So it really kind of feels like you're either swimming through it or you're, like, walking through it and the floor's down there. It's just mostly flooded. It's, yeah. One of the reasons I would never want to be like my buddy Mark from Beyond the Films, who does all the caving and stuff. I'd be like, oh, I'd get in a situation like this and be like, hell no. Hell no, sorry. Nope. Hell no, sorry. But no, it's okay. It's a, sorry, just some gas. I promise that was me, right? Was that me? Can I pass gas and not know it? Oh, shit. Duck under again. Oh, look, it can't be that bad. Oh, motherfucker! Is that Andre? Maybe. I just leave this right here. It's cool. It's cool. And there's, like, people on the wall. Lots of people. Maybe those missing people? Oh. Oh, hey. It's a dungeon-y place, because, you know, that's always good. But at least if you need... At least we need to take a crap wire in the dungeon. Apparently you can. Oh, look, needles. You may recall that in the demo, when you get the handgun out of the toilet, there's also hypodermic needles in there, too. The... Okay, that looks like... That may be Mia. Okay, awesome. Hmm... This list here. That was Peter and Andre both listed as dead. Clancy listed as L. And you got all your turn, dead, etc., etc. Turned into what? You can flip it around. Look at the other side. Oh, look, the only one that's not listed as turned or dead is Mia. And she appears to be in that little side room. So here's our bolt cutters, since they weren't in their original location. Okay, cool. Let's go save Mia now. And hope she's not a monster. Because she is kind of locked up. Hopefully that means she's a prisoner, right? When you get to any of these interactive points, you will have to go through your inventory. Don't just immediately go click, click, because you may wind up clicking on something that's not of use. You do have to actually navigate the menu. Floaty. And okay, I'll tell you up front here that from the standpoint of VR games, usually you're kind of close to individuals, but it's usually from like a fixed perspective type of thing, like in Batman Arkham VR. It takes a lot to really get the sense of immersion with the idea that like a person is right there in front of you, especially and have it feel like they're the right size of a human being relative to you standing there. But they did an incredible job with this for Mia, which is both awesome and immersive and freaky as shit as we move later on in this beginning hour. But, honey, I'm home.
Mia, thank God I found you. It's me. It's Ethan.
Ethan?
Are you all right?
You shouldn't be here.
What do you mean? You contacted me.
No, I wouldn't. Did I? Did anyone see you? Did he see you?
He? What the hell's going on?
Daddy's coming. We need to go.
Dad?
Daddy?
We need to go now!
Okay. Are you sure you're okay there, honey?
Where are you taking me?
Someplace safe.
Are you gonna tell me what's going on? Baby, you've been gone 3 years.
3 years? Has it really been 3 years?
Definitely not back the way that we came. I was just back that way. Chains and shit. Oddly, nothing to interact with.
Mia, we have to talk. That message you sent me.
Not me. That wasn't me.
But you did.
I didn't.
Okay, fine. Just tell me what's going on.
I'm telling you everything that I know.
Didn't you?
We have to.
Weren't you going
to
explain later? And you are telling me what? Okay. Your head is directing your flashlight here, by the way.
Are you sure you know where you're going?
Family used to
Candle
make it. Food through here. I remember.
Okay. Again, you think that's creepy from an immersion standpoint? Try walking into it. Okay. If it wasn't for that whole fade in, fade out afterwards, I'd be like, oh shit. And I'm not even claustrophobic.
It's there.
It's a door. Sweet.
This is it.
Okay, so open it. It's like a study.
Remember this room. There's another
kind
door
of?
Here. I'm sure of it. It's not here. It's gone!
The door's gone? Are you sure you're not just batshit crazy?
Now that you're here.
We'll be
a
fam? What the fuck are you talking about? Picture of like an old grandma kind of lady. Okay. All right. Now this may start looking familiar to you if you were playing the demo. This is that downstairs storage room from the demo, where you gotta get the attic key. Got a doll. Uh-oh. Honey? Shit. Hey, honey, you were right, there was a door. Sorry. That's where your lockpick is in the demo. Now the lighting is different, but the design is similar. Okay. 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 Nothing. All right. We're back upstairs, and there's a phone, which is just going to give me a busy signal because nobody's calling it. There's not any ammo up there like there is in the demo. Let's try this. Anything? Oh, a guest housed map. So yes, now you can click it, and you got your map. So you got your objectives on the left, but now your map that tells you where you are. And yes, this is the guest house that you were in for the entire beginning hour demo. Got the email, the list of names, front and back. Okay. Interesting. Bathroom? First aid. Excellent. Nothing in the medicine cabinet this time. And it is pouring down. And somebody's knocking. Okay. First time I walked out into this hallway when I played this briefly. That's gonna be locked. The thunder and lightning effects in the 3D audio is just incredible. Okay, so this is the only way I can go. And I was just down there, but now somebody's, like, knocking down there. Okay. And now is when the beginning hour becomes so much more interesting than the beginning hour. Hello? Honey? Are you asthmatic? Hello? Oh, shit. Motherfucker! Oh! Ow. Domestic violence. Shit! Ow!
Wait!
Alright, stop it! Stop it, stop it, stop it, stop it, stop it, stop it! Stop it! Ow! Damn!
I can hear her. I can feel her clawing her way back inside of me. Leave me alone! I'm mad. I deserve this.
Oh.
The fuck are you, Mia?
What are you? Well, I guess that was accurate. R1. Use a little first aid stuff. Okay, well. In the words of Axl Rose, you're fucking crazy, old child. Yeah, right there, honey? Oh, shit! Just checking. Ow. Oh shit. Got an axe. Honey, I don't want to do this, but... You're nuts! Ow. Oh! Shit, did I just kill my wife? Did I just... Aw, damn it. Okay. Okay, well, now that I've gone all OJ, let's go answer the phone. Nothing to see here! Hello?
You really shouldn't have come here.
Who's this? And what the fuck is going on?
My name's Zoe. There should be a way out through the attic.
Attic?
Okay.
Go there. Now.
But I can't get to the attic because I don't have the damn fuse. Okay. Alrighty then. Alrighty then. And... Oh goody, she's not in there anymore. Fantastic. Oh good, at least I've got an axe still. Mother! That was the bathroom. Yeah, bathroom already checked. Okay, good. So, the attic. Alright, I'm in rough shape. Let's do it. I'll have another here momentarily. I'll clear up my vision. I do have it set on normal for the amount of blood that it shows. Okay, cool. That's fine. That is fine, honey. Because I got one place I haven't checked for shit. Because it's different than the demo, so I'm just gonna take my Ethan-y ass over here. Quick turn back in circle. And bolt cutter this bitch. And yes, the fuse. Which makes sense because the VHS tape was already elsewhere. Oh, damn it. I'm not trying to wanna kill the wifey.
But she ain't making it easy.
Okay. I still can't do anything up there because I won't be able to press the button until I put the fuse in, so... Okay. That's lovely and all. Alright, let's put that fuse in here. Okay. And we'll just head on upstairs. Mother!
It's okay. It's me.
What you got behind your back, honey?
I know you didn't mean to
what
hurt
do you have behind your back? Ah.
You shouldn't have done that! Fucking
horse! Ow. Ow. What you got there? Aw, mother...
Now, let's see how you feel.
I didn't cut anything off of you! I just, like, axed you, honey!
I promise, must burn it all down.
shit. Okay. I guess I'll take my hand back. Can I? Crouching. Oh, got my hand.
Ew. You can't dodge with it either.
Okay. I guess I'll go to the attic now. Fat fucking lot of good it's gonna do me.
Another area from the demo, but changed. Now we just got a little room and that's closed off. No telephone, but hey, handgun ammo. Woohoo! His own, bitch.
Okay, fine.
Even he's like, alright, honey, we're fucking done with this shit. Notice I'm aiming with my head. I can still move around, but the left stick, or excuse me, the right stick has nothing to do with aiming anymore. In VR, it's all point and shoot. Or point and shoot. Okay. Let's switch to the axe. Anything? Any ammo? Any ammo? Nope. All righty then. And now this is not boarded up anymore. This becomes our access point to that back area. No key, but hey, there's ammo. I'll take it. One of the murder sites up there. Nope.
Tiny mannequins!
And crates that don't have anything in them! Don't they know this is Resident Evil? Crates have to have stuff in them. But there aren't any of the special kind that are in the demo yet. Okay, we're gonna switch to the gun just in case I need that momentarily. This is where, of course, you found the dirty coin. At the end of the demo as you head towards the true ending. I'm pretty sure that that didn't shake because of me. Just to be on the safe side. I feel better now. Okay. So, it's unlocked. That's a nice welcome change from the demo. Sweet. I hear something. Oh. We're gonna need some counseling after this shit. You suck, honey.
Yeah. They were always watching me. Why?
Ow.
Please.
Oh. Given that I've already messed up a couple times, I'm kind of tempted to let her kill me because that looks freaky as shit. Yep, there we go. Yeah, it's what happened to me the first time, too. On the plus side, they have nifty little help items that you can actually skim through. Oh, now I'm going to have to take it to her, and I'm actually going to have to do it right this time. Okay.
Okay, fine.
la la. On the plus side, if it's scripted events, you kind of know when to be careful and when you can just freaking run and save yourself some time. Like right here. Okay. Let's try this again. We're gonna get the hell away. See if I can actually hit her. Nope, she's gonna hit me no matter what, apparently. Honey. I always imagined this would be the way it would be. Taking care of your mother, not you, honey. Except, big downside. Yeah, the ladder's gone. That's not gonna do me any good.
Welcome to the family, son.
Boom! Kind of like the backdoor ending of the beginning hour. Again, we're back in that cinematic mode instead of being in full VR at this point. Same thing whenever he just got hit and fell down next to Mia. It went to cinematic for the cutscene-esque element.
Don't you die on us now. You have work to do.
Still cinematic. Hey, I've got my hand back in some kind of monitor. That's nice. Creepy loading. Long loading. Back in full VR.
Where am I? What the hell?
Rise and shine, sleepyhead. It's time for supper.
Who are all you people? Where's Mia?
Eat it. It's good.
Dumb son bitch wasn't no good if it hit him.
Strapped down, being told to eat. Oh. Again?
The boy's got to eat. He got to have his supper. Come here, boy.
This is one creepy big dude. That is actually at your mouth level, so it looks like it just went in your mouth and then you spit it out. Nothing you can do for that.
God damn it. I'll bet it's that cop again. God damn pigs.
I'm coming back. Blue Lives Matter, asshole. What you talking about? You gonna take apparently dead grandma or whatever the fuck? You're not? Okay, Dan. Okay. Okay. All right. Okay. And then at this point, all of your stuff is gone. All right, so you might as well use those healths while you can, it looks like. And you're left alone momentarily. You're going to have to find a way, ironically, to escape from the house, which is basically your thing during your objective during the beginning hour, the demo. You'll find a few things in here, but not really much. Like a little bit of bullets, a story about the guys who were trying to film the haunted house type thing. What appear to be recipes for human beings. An exit you can't do anything with yet. An herb. Apparently health herbs still exist. Nothing in the fridge. That's nasty as hell. Anything in these? I don't believe there were. Nope, gotta have a lockpick apparently or something. Nope. Locked from the other side. And then this is much more stealth apparently. Because this guy will beat your ass if he spots you. You got a garage area? Hey, I could go in the garage. Maybe I can break it with something. I don't have my axe anymore. Yes, good. Thank you for telling me it's the garage. Oh, hey, I can leave out through the garage. Oh, no. And yeah, this is the point that you've probably seen in the demos where you can run into him and he's not going to be happy. Dinner was done. What are you doing, you crazy hickerbilly? Run! Run away, run away! Uh-oh. Run away, run! Shit! Oh. Don't know what that is! Don't know why I need it now!
Just shut up!
You hearing voices, bro? I can recommend a good shrink. Or a bad one. Take your... Oh, hey, it's a bobblehead. Aw, damn! Okay, let me just let myself get murdered here, because we're right at about the point where I wanted to stop. But! Come on!
You're alone! And now
you are dead. And there we go. So that's actually more like what the actual beginning hour of Resident Evil 7 is like. Not sure how I feel about the dad thing just yet. I'm like, yeah, weird hickerbilly guy trying to kill you, blah, 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 Texas Chainsaw Massacre, whatever. But yeah, I have to admit, knowing that we were going to see the wife again from seeing some reviews, I expected that to be later in the game. Finding her so early and having her turn out to be crazy girl from the ring or something. Yeah. And the few jump scares there and just... I mean, really, when you're playing it, it's hard to tell from just watching a video of it or even watching a video of someone who is in VR, because you're really just sort of seeing what I'm seeing, except maybe the bottom edge of the image, as I'm in the loading room again here. But just being in there, having the water kind of up to your neck, having her like right in your face, and especially when she kills you with the chainsaw, I mean, she is right up in your face. It's about as close, if not closer, than the way that it felt if you ever played the kitchen demo, which was the other publicly available demo for Resident Evil 7. So, thought you might get a kick out of that. Hopefully you'll be checking out Resident Evil 7 if you're into survival horror. I am pretty stoked with it so far. It does not disappoint, has not disappointed thus far, though I really need to figure out what to do next, of course. But that will come with a little bit of experimentation. And of course, again, if you want to play Resident Evil 7 and you don't have PlayStation VR, no problem. You can play it completely outside of VR in just regular first person. But as soon as you put on that VR headset and you get this type of immersion in the environment, it is a whole new ballgame. This, I think, and it is actually for a buddy of mine, Jeff, I think this is going to wind up being a PlayStation VR seller for many people. This will be a killer app, and it is a VR exclusive for PlayStation, at least for the first year the game is out. And then on PC, it can come to Rift and Vive. So as you're looking ahead, this may be one to check out. With that, though, I am going to head out of here. Hope you enjoyed it, and I will be checking out more PSVR and other live streams, and maybe even some more Resident Evil 7, perhaps, in the coming days and months. Thanks, everybody.